Here's what it looks like when filled. No, we don't want to do this.
Ziggy E. I got one more problem with your girl. Hey. Ziggy E.
I am going to show you two ways of applying the ombre lips because I absolutely love them. You can do it with all sorts of color combinations. I'm going to use three colors today. Alright, let's get started. So ombre lips are always about darker shade on the outer side and lighter shade on the inner side. I have the two light shades which are gonna go in and one dark shade which is gonna go out. These are from a brand called Party Queen. I got them from beauty center and I have been in love with the formula. Everybody asks me what I'm wearing on my lips every time I wear these. All the three pencils are from same brand. I am gonna go back to beauty center and buy lots more. The best part is that I think these were only for 150 or 190 bucks each. Crazy steal deal. First method goes this way, that the lighter shade, whichever lighter shade you pick, so I'm picking this one. Name of the color, if you'd like, is citrine and number is 11. So the first method is to apply the lighter shade all over your lips. And once you're done with that, pick up the darker shade and start outlining the lip. The name of this color is deep red and the number is 16. I am just going to outline this. Don't bring it inside, just outline it. Now going back to school days, do you remember that we always stopped here and this looks such like a cartoon character? Well, no, we will not stop here. We are just going to blend this. And how? Not by a brush or not by using anything else, just with the help of our lips. Now, if you are not used to doing these lip movements, which I'm just gonna show you, you might need a little practice, which you can do at home. But once you perfect this technique, there is no going back. All you require is to understand the shape of your lips, because every lip shape is different in the world, right? So understand the shape of your lips and do it the way you would be perfectly comfortable with it. So all I'm gonna do is smudge the lower lip, the line and the inside lipstick with the help of upper lip, and I'm gonna smudge the upper lip with the help of lower lip. Easier said than done. Well, let's look at it. It goes like this. Do you see? It's all smudged. This line is not smudged, but this is, because I use the upper lip to do the lower lip. Now I'm gonna use the lower lip to do the upper lip. Now if you feel that you have lost the inside color, obviously go back and reapply it. You can absolutely stop right here, but I like the outer lines to be a little more stark, so I'm just gonna take the darker shade, and this time around I'm not going to apply it all over my lips. I'm just going to apply it on the middle section of the lip, on the top and the bottom lip, but just on the middle section. And on the lower section, just right below the cupid's bow. So I like it when I stop here. You can stop at any stage, and ta-da! That's how you achieve ombre lips. I don't want to wipe this off, but let's move on to the second method of doing this. It's actually just the reversal of the first one. So in the first method, we applied the inner shade, then we applied the outer shade. This time around, we are just going to first apply the outer shade and then the inner shade. My personal preference is the first method. So here is our darker shade, the deep red, a maroonish shade. Obviously, I'm just gonna simply line my lips with it. I'm not going to apply it all over the lips, just lining them. I am absolutely in love with the consistency and the formula of this product. It's so creamy, it's crazy. And then I'm going to take the lighter shade, any of these. I mean, I am using the light pink one. You can use whatever shade you want, just in the same family of the color. And I'm going to fill in the inside. So while I'm filling in, I am going to try to blend both the colors in. Here's what it looks like when filled. No, we don't want to do this. Now using the pencil, let's start blending. I'm going to take the light pencil almost till the borders and completely cover the darker shade. You see that how it looks nice and blended, yet the darker color is still showing up for the final blend. That's it. So yeah, there you go. Those were the two ways of applying ombre lipsticks. You can obviously play with a lot of colors. Purple and black would look amazing. These two colors that I showed you guys were on the regular daily basis stuff. It looks very sexy, very sultry. It immediately makes your lips look absolutely pouty and nice. As you can see, my whole makeup has just fallen into place with just this one nice way of using lipsticks. I absolutely love and adore ombre lips. I feel that they are extremely sexy yet classy. They just makes you look so very elegant and nice. So obviously, you know the drill. If you loved this video, please give it a huge thumbs up. Please share it with your friends. If you want lot more tips and tricks, let me know in the comments below. If you have any specific request or suggestion of any specific part as to how to apply blush, how to contour and all of that, let me know in the comments below. I will make small videos based on specific subjects. If you're wondering how I got this look, this is just one product on my face. I don't really have powder or concealer or contour or anything, not even highlighter. And as you can see, my skin is like glowing from within. So if you'd like to know more about how I got this look, I have just one product on my face, like slapped on my face right now, check this video right here. I will link two more videos below in the description box on how to get these amazing eyebrows and how to make your real lashes look like they are fake lashes right here. So check those videos and spread the love, share it with your friends. I love you guys. Thank you for subscription and I'll see you in my next. Bye.